Russ Martin Show.
Again, but do it slower.
Okay. It's a little bit out of tune, but whatever. You can do it. You can do it.
Maybe the first one.
See, and your finger is already in position for that second.
Go back to the first one.
Okay.
Let me see. You got no strap?
Finger and third fret, and then you're going to try to create an A chord with, yeah, your first finger across there. There you go. Yep, there you go. That's your A chord, buddy.
What is this one? This one?
That's just the root. That's just the first little
note. How many times I hit that one?
Hit that twice. And then the A chord twice. Back to the other one.
Twice again?
Once. And then A chord once. There you go, and I just put all that together.
Move!
There you go. That's almost it.
Yeah, that was fun. That's what's going to happen.
You're going to kick into that?
That's
the only thing you know.
4 years, I still don't have Highway to Hell down.
Hey,
I'm not learning this one in a night.
Yeah, one more time.
Yeah, give it a try, yeah.
Plus, this ain't all of it. This is just the beginning.
Oh.
Here?
Yep.
And then there.
And back at the, yeah.
Is that me or the guitar?
That's the guitar.
Am I supposed to mute it like that?
Yep.
Is that the right
pacing? Yeah. Uh-huh. That's all right. That's it. That's good.
Jesus. See? There.
You always want to go back to your comfort zone.
All right. Tell them I ain't going to learn it.
Okay.
A day's not enough time. They should have told me a few years ago.
If you just practiced like once a week, it would be good enough for these little things. Because you've got an awesome amp, you got two great guitars at home. Just once a week, it's all you would need.
To do what?
Just to be able to, you know, pick up on a little better. You'd have more fun with it too. And wouldn't it be cool to be able to go out to a bar or something, hanging out? And get on stage with a band. Because I guarantee you, everybody knows You Really Got Me. I mean, that's one of the easiest songs out there.
Not enough notice.
We'll keep trying. We'll see.
All right. You want to start news again?
Sure.
Is that a pissy chick?
It looks that way, but not really pissy, just matter of fact.
Mm-hmm. Yes, what is it?
Hey, Russ. It's Cindy.
Hi, Cindy.
I'm not a pissy chick. I just done call and tell I'm a listener. I listen to you every day, but you shouldn't talk to your mama that way. She ought to snatch you bald headed.
Why?
Well, you put her out in the grove.
I didn't put her there. She picked the grove. She picked Pleasant Grove. I had nothing to do with that.
Well,
it's not like I grew up and then said, you know, where's where can I stick her that she won't enjoy? Well, I'll get her a nice house in the Grove.
If her and George want to get out and hooky it all up all night long, that's their business.
He can have her. Yeah, I don't care anymore. Just take her.
Yes, you
can. I'm not going to fall for this blackmail.
Brilliant on her part.
Well, it's not going to work.
Well,
go get some George. Eat it all.
No.
You're not getting a house out of this. You're not getting a house. You're not living with me. Just if you
just keep her away from George.
Keep from being a whore.
No. Please don't say that about your mom.
What is she going to do? Well, she's going to go out with a limo driver, get all sexed up, and then bang him in the back of the car. What's that?
That's you don't know none of any of that's going to happen. And don't talk about your mother that way.
Whore.
God.
I won't be a whore if you'll buy me a house.
She never said a whore. She said, was. I'll follow your rules if I'm under your roof.
And that means don't be a whore. And you know damn well, if she lived with me, she'd sneak George in the back.
Shimmy up the old drain pipe. I'd pay money to see that.
Then you hear stuff going on upstairs. Slobbering, bones breaking, and just all kinds of weird sexual crap. Mm-hmm. No.
I'm with you on that.
All right, you ready to go?
Yes.
Did you do a legal ID at 5?
Yes.
All right, then. All right, 5:15, J.D. Ryan's here with news.
Thank you, Russ. If you're looking for Live 5 tickets, you can come out tomorrow night. Or, excuse me, yes, tonight.
You're looking for what tickets?
Live 5.
Oh.
Live 5 tickets. Chloe will have them tonight at the Beagle, Greenville Avenue in Dallas. She'll be there from 9 to 11 o'clock.
So you can't even teach this to me tonight. You're going out.
Yeah.
What time's the Beagle thing?
The Beagle thing's 9 to 11, and I'm Everett. No, Everett's got band practice tonight.
All right, F it. I ain't doing it.
What?
All right.
Let them learn something I know.
You only know one song.
All right, it's easy enough. What are we talking about? Three or four chords? Yeah. Probably one of the easiest songs to learn, isn't it?
That was very easy. Actually, I didn't know it until I saw you playing it.
All right, so. There. They're a big band. They can learn crap like that.
Probably.
Tell them to learn Highway to Hell. Go ahead.
Into that. Well, Texas is officially a majority-minority state now, thanks largely to Latino population growth. Non-Hispanic whites dipped under the majority mark in Texas around July of 2004, that's according to the U.S. Census Bureau. A minority now makes up about 50.2% of the state's population. Texas now joins California, Hawaii, and New Mexico as a majority-slash-minority state. Sometime before 2030, by the way, every single major city in Texas is going to have a Latino majority. At Parkland Hospital, by the way, 8 out of 10 newborn babies are Latino, and the number one radio station in Dallas is now Spanish.
Well, as a side story to the number one station being Spanish, we just can't talk about it.
That's true. That is true. Well, there's a side story also to 8 out of 10 babies at Parkland.
What's the side story on that?
Well, if you go to Plano, it probably wouldn't be 8 out of 10. I mean, they're picking Parkland Hospital. That's the city hospital where, you know, if you don't have a lot of money, that's chances are that's where you go. But it is true. I mean, this... You know, Hispanics have a lot of kids.
I don't know if it's just because they're horny or because they're Catholic.
Are they Catholic?
Isn't that predominantly what Hispanics are?
Yeah.
Catholic?
And they don't do any kind of
birth control.
Birth control.
Obviously not.
They'll have 5 or 6 children, and the average white couple will have 2.
Because we're not in Fuego.
Do the math, yeah.
So by 2013 what? Or 2030 what?
2030, every single major city in Texas will have Latino majority.
We got nowhere to go.
No, we don't.
Where do we run?
There's nowhere to run.
You know, that's what all the white people are thinking. Well, now we're the minority. Where are we going to go? They're coming after us. They were talking about that when I was in high school. The birth rate of Hispanics versus whites. I think they even projected. I think when I was in school, they said by 2010... there'd be more Hispanics than whites.
Well,
so that was a pretty close projection.
Yeah, I missed it by a few years, but not by much. Just growing a little faster than expected. It's real simple. Just do the math. I mean, it's going to continue like this. It's not going to get any better. It's not gonna, suddenly, they're not going to start having 1 or 2 kids.
Are you saying it's bad?
I'm just saying it's happening. I'm reporting the news.
Well,
I'm
you not said
commenting
it's
a, on the
you
news.
Said it's not going to get any better. What does that mean?
It just means it's not going to get any different.
It means we got no place to go. Hold on. What is it?
That's the wrong one.
What is it, Kevin?
Hey, man.
You know what? I've listened to you for years.
All right. That's very kind of you to call. Go ahead.
Sure. This story, Rob has been freaking out about all day long. By the way, your little appearance tomorrow night, he's got security.
You fart again?
If I did, I didn't even recognize it. I'm sorry. I was going to leave. I'm sorry.
All right.
All right, what's he freaking about?
He's got security people. What did he call it? Advance. He's got an advance team going out today to Firewire for your security tomorrow night.
Why?
Because he worried about this. One of the more interesting stories of this week is the indictment of John A. Jr. Gotti, son of John Gotti, the former and deceased head of the New York Gambino family. Jr. Gotti was charged with various crimes, including taking instructions from his father to organize a hit on the New York talk show host.
I thought that was a couple of weeks ago.
Tell me, was it? But this, he gave this to me today. He goes, see what's happening? They're all after the radio talk show hosts. I'm
who's Gotti after?
Gotti's after this, is it Sliwa? The Curtis, the guy from the Angels.
Sliwa. Is that right?
Curtis, yeah. And that guy, and actually Sliwa's had to go.
Why are they after him?
Oh, he's here already. He's already in prison on other convictions. Gotti is. It'll be arraigned July 30th for conspiracy, kidnapping, and attempted murder.
Why are they after the radio guy?
Because basically he got on the radio and talked bad about the Gottis. Now he's gone underground.
Where'd he go?
The Angels, well, underground. He's in hiding. Away from the mob.
I didn't say nothing about the Gottis.
I know, but Rob's just freaking out about you going out in public tomorrow night. You'll have an advanced security team. Oh, he's not the president. Come on, man.
I'm not going.
Why are you not going?
It's just getting too freaky.
Well, that's
right. I can't go out in public without Rob wigging out because the Gambino
talk show host.
Give me the story.
He's worried about Paul too.
Paul who?
Your
Sliwa?
No, your death right guy. Wow.
New York radio host Curtis Sliwa goes into hiding. One of the more interesting stories this week is the indictment of John A. Jr. Gotti, son of John Gotti, former and deceased head of the New York Gambino family. Junior Gotti was charged with various crimes, including taking instructions from his father to organize a hit on New York talk show host Curtis Sliwa, now heard on News Talk 777 WABC. In 92, Sliwa was shot in a cab but managed to escape the vehicle and survive the attack. Afterwards, he always maintained it was retribution from the mob for his outspoken remarks on the John Gotti Sr. Sliwa went into hiding after his morning show on Friday, now fearing retaliation from organized crime in response to this week's indictment. This was in New York?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What kind of dumbass bags on a mob family in New York?
I don't know.
What did he think was going to happen?
I don't know. But Rob's freaking out. It just adds more fuel to his fire.
There's no fuel here. You got some guy on the radio. I don't care how outspoken you want to be or how big of a stand-up guy. If the mob is in your city, you don't get on the air and call them pussies.
You wouldn't think.
Rob, you can cancel security. I'm not going.
I'm not canceling because tomorrow at 6:45, you're going to decide to go, and by then it'll be too late. So they've already done what they need to do today, and they'll be ready tomorrow at your house and on site.
What's to do? What are they going to do there tomorrow night? Is it tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night.
They're checking the venue and all of the available entry and exit ways. And if you're going to do this stage thing, they're going to have a couple of people there too. So
I'm not doing the stage thing. I can't learn this song in a day.
You're still going to be on stage because of the Gavin thing.
Mm-mm. I said I would go. I didn't say I'd get on stage if Gavin dressed up like the Daisy Duke.
I thought if he shot stuff off his head, you'd get on stage.
He's got two more.
I got two more shots?
Two or three.
Three. Three more shots.
Yeah, where's Gavin?
Gavin.
Yeah.
Get in here. Where's my BB gun?
Oh, God. It's like a sporting goods store in here.
What?
Ready to go. Yeah,
between the mini bike and the blow up raft.
All right. Here he comes.
What do we got over there to shoot?
Coffee craver.
What are the cans?
Great Pond. Oh. Big K-Cola cans.
Are they empty?
Yes.
Well, that's not any fun. Stick the mustard on his head.
Mustard?
Yeah.
If I do this, you're coming tomorrow night, right?
Maybe. You gonna hurry up?
I just want you to say hi and then move on.
All right, Claude, put it on.
Stay where you're gonna stand.
Yeah. All right, you ready? Is that a yes? What?
Don't move.
Wow. Give me the mustard back.
Nice shot.
Did it? I think it bounced off.
Did it?
Yep.
I didn't pierce that. Give me something good. Take one of the cans. Put it on your head. Yeah. It's not as much fun if they're not in, if they're
don't explode, yeah.
Yeah. Wet it.
No!
Damn
it!
Got me in
the heel.
That's a good one.
Did it ricochet?
Yeah, ricochet right in my heel. That's good.
I got one more?
One more.
Let me shoot you. Let me shoot the helmet.
No!
Why?
Oh, come on. That's
it's not going to go through that helmet.
Motorcycle helmet. It's made for wrecks.
That's going to make it vibrate.
I won't. Shoot you in the helmet.
Yeah.
No.
That's fair.
I'll take the helmet off and you can shoot it.
No.
There's a human inside this helmet.
It's not going to go through the helmet.
Well, I don't know that.
You saw it didn't go through the mustard. It's not going through the helmet.
Well, it's my head.
I told you he's smart.
I know he is good.
We're waiting. What else I got to shoot over there, Clint?
Balloon.
Now, give me a can with something in it. Hurry up. One out of the cooler. Not one of those. Those are expensive. Okay. Give me one of the cheap Big K ones. They got my energy drink stuff. It's a couple of dollars a can.
Don't do that.
Yeah, that's fine. Put it up there. Well, you got to get out of the way. Move.
Careful.
Stop jiggling. Stop it.
Don't. I'm going to shoot him in the head.
He can't hear us.
Yes. He'll be fine. It'll just bounce off.
All right, thanks. Better run.
That's good.
All right. Blow this one. Okay. Another stellar radio bit.
So you'll be there tomorrow.
I don't know. If I'm messing with all this stuff, it's not worth it. It's not worth the grief. I don't know why all of a sudden he's wigged out. I made it this long. Nobody's killed me. This Paul guy's been calling for, what, month and a half before we went on vacation?
Yes.
Nothing's happened with that. I don't even get good gifts from him.
I know.
The phone calls are useless. There's nothing going on. Not once has there ever been one thing you could point at that said, yeah, okay, that's this really is dangerous. This is a death threat you need to pay attention to.
I agree.
And why do the death threats? Just do it. Why give me the heads up? Why let me watch for it?
It's the fear factor. I'll make him sweat.
It's because you're not going to do it. If you're really going to do it, you just pop me and get it over with. I'm tired of waiting on your ass. We don't have time for news?
We started it.
Oh. All right, we're going.
Continue. Okay. My bad. Sorry. Several Texas congressmen quietly circulating a proposal, you'll like this one, to approve deputized civilians as an auxiliary to the U.S. Border Patrol. The so-called Border Protection Corps would consist of volunteers who go through a background check and receive training and would then accompany Border Patrol officers as they search for illegal aliens and drug activity. These would be volunteers who go through training, don't have criminal backgrounds, don't use firearms, and basically would serve as backup capacity to the Border Patrol. Basically, let's see here, U.S. Representative Lamar Smith, who's a Republican, is one of the big backers of it. The chief sponsor, U.S. Republican, John Culberson, compares the Border Patrol Corps to the posse, which brought the criminals in the days of the Western frontier. Don't say it.
I don't have anything to say. Then I got to take my idea, stick more Border Patrol down there. That's why us can live in fresh water.
Yes, they can. According to researchers, as many as one out of every 25 fathers could be unknowingly raising another man's child. In other words, 4% of fathers are raising some other guy's kid. That study came from studies in the U.S., Finland, New Zealand, South Africa, and Mexico. Professor Mark Bellis, one of the researchers, says some of the cases are just because of mix-up. It's basically an artificial insemination, but the majority are due to women who've had affairs. You're raising some kid that's not even yours.
I understand.
Forbes magazine has just released a list of the best cars for singles, and here are some of them. The very best car for boosting your sex life is a BMW 6 Series convertible, sexy convertible, goes very fast, and $77,000.
What's that one?
That is the BMW 6 Series convertible.
All right.
Best for boosting your sex life. That is best for boosting your sex life. It's sexy.
All right.
You look sexier.
I got it.
Best car for a 45-year-old single guy, the Chevrolet Corvette. It's an icon of masculinity. What?
I bought it before I hit 45. I don't know why they associate that with a middle-aged crisis. Who can afford a Corvette in their 20s?
But fit your midlife crisis better than in your early 20s.
You can't afford a Corvette at that age.
That's true.
That's the point where you can... What's a base on a Corvette now?
52.2.
That's for probably an 06, because I didn't pay that much for mine.
Okay.
I mean an 05.
Nothing. It says that's the best one for a 45-year-old guy going through a midlife crisis.
I'm not going through a crisis.
No, I know. You can just know.
A crisis if you got a family and you're trying to get out of it. I'm trying to stay out of it.
You are. You're doing a very good job.
I'm being proactive.
I might say. Best car for a 45-year-old single woman is a Mercedes-Benz SLK class. It's faster, sexier, more comfortable, and it's about $47,000. And also the very best car for a newly divorced dad is a Lotus Elise, I suppose. It's the opposite of the family car. It's $43,000.
All right.
Moving forward here. A new survey by the Oregon State University finds that many black Americans distrust the government when it comes to birth control. A survey of 500 black Americans say only 50% believe that the government tells the truth about the safety and side effects of new birth control methods. 33% believe that the medical institutions use poor or minority people as guinea pigs to try out new birth control methods. What was that?
What a shock.
Not? 25% agree that poor and minority women are sometimes forced to be sterilized by the government. Please. Forced. And 22% agree that the government family planning policies are intended to control the number of black people. Stop it.
I got nothing to say.
Like we spray or something.
I don't want to do that just to black people. I want to do it to everybody.
I know you do.
Just run through and hit all the McFrugals in the dollar stores. Spray them all.
You can't.
Yeah, you can. No. Just tell them you're spraying for skeeters and spray them.
Yeah, we get the West now.
Yeah.
Mostly down here in the Grove.
Just sterilize all those areas. And you know what? If you have more than one if you got several kids, I think at a certain point the state does come in and say, all right, here's the deal. You don't have any more kids. You have any more kids, we're not paying for any more because we're going to sterilize your ass.
Can't. It'll never happen.
We're not going to pay for the 4 or 5 that you got unless you get sterilized. You let us have them eggs. You're abusing them.
Never happen.
Give us those eggs.
ACLU would never let that happen in this case.
Why?
They just won't. They're never going
to. You're not entitled to money just because you keep having kids?
You are in this country as of now, and I don't believe you'll ever get that right will ever be taken from you.
That needs to change then. I'll let you have 4 kids. You want me to keep paying for those 4 kids?
That's a fair number.
You give us the eggs.
That's a fair number.
You've run amok with those things. You've got plenty of usage out of them. Give them to us. We'll keep paying for the 4 kids. You don't give us the eggs, We're not paying for your kids anymore.
Can you hear the screams of Big Brother?
No, that's not Big Brother.
After four?
I'm not trying to control anything. I'm trying to keep from having to pay for everything that you're having. So not only do I got to pay for it because you're low income, I got to pay for your schooling.
Only if I'm on government assistance then?
Yeah.
Okay. Because, you know, today there's another big day down at the state fair, right? They gave away all the school supplies to the underprivileged again today.
What about
Laura Miller was behind that. That's just another day where they were giving away, I think they expected 60,000 kids.
Well, that was all private donations. I don't give a rat's ass.
Okay.
You want to help somebody like that? That's dandy. I appreciate it. But you did it because you wanted to. Don't force me to do it. Just because you keep squatting out kids doesn't mean I need to keep writing checks. Knock it off. Or give me the eggs. Stop it.
You've been running amok with the eggs.
You have more. There's no reason to have more than four kids.
Well, absolutely. Especially if you can't pay for them. You're right, but it ain't going to happen. But you are correct. They'll never do it.
At a certain point, it's got to stop. And if you don't know how to control those eggs, you give them to me.
Come get them.
They're coming out. We're going to scoop those bitches out.
New study by Risk Advisory Group finds that, here's a shock, 25% of people lie on their resumes. Study looked at almost 3,000.
Why not? Who checks them?
I don't think anybody does.
You're going to call? You know, if I put I had a degree at North Texas, you're going to call them and ask?
I don't
you want to see it? You want to see a degree?
I got
desktop publishing.
Yeah, you can print up almost anything.
So why would they check?
I don't think they do.
Or why
unless
not
it's
lie?
Something like a doctor or something. You're going to be a doctor. They probably check on that.
Yeah, that's pretty close to what I was going to say. I think it just depends on the job, and of course, it depends on the company. In other words, I think the higher ranking position that you're going for, like let's say you were applying for a CEO position,
right?
I'm pretty sure that they would check just to make sure you actually graduated.
Well, by the time you're a CEO, you're going to have a track record of where you've been. You know, you're not going to come out of the mailroom and apply for a CEO position.
Well, yeah, and that's very true. And for the mailroom, they may not do that, but again, if it's a higher-ranking position, more than likely, if they're going to go to the extent of interviewing you, calling all your references.
I got it.
The average resume contains three pieces of misleading information, unless you're Daedalus. Last Friday, a man in Henry County, Georgia, got off early, his graveyard shift, about 5:30 in the morning. As he approached his house, he saw an unoccupied police car in his driveway, a little concerned that there might be a crime going on.
Oh, I read about that.
Actually, he went inside, and there was a crime going on. There was a cop inside.
Screwing his daughter.
Yeah. 28-year-old Randolph Cobain was having sex with his 16-year-old daughter. The dad freaked out, called the cops, took him a minute to figure out who to send because Randolph was actually on duty and technically would have been the officer to respond. Eventually, they sent over another officer, and Randolph was arrested. He's been charged with one count of sexual molestation and one count of aggravated sexual molestation. He's also been fired from the police department. You may wonder how they got together. He started out volunteering as a swim coach at her high school.
Don't want to take line 8. Yeah. Hi, Jason. All right, what did he want?
He works for a charity that helps the homeless, and he said that Mayor Miller only allows them to feed the homeless sandwiches, like peanut butter and jelly, no hot meals.
Why?
Because she doesn't want to take care of the homeless. And then he was also saying, and she wonders why it is that our crime rate is what it is. I guess he seems to think if they get soup as opposed to sandwich.
A hot meal would keep somebody from robbing me?
That's what he thinks.
I'll look into that.
Okay.
Thanks. 79-year-old Monsignor Eugene Clark of St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York City been busted for having a long-term affair with his married female secretary, 46-year-old Laura DeFilippo. The big irony of this is, of course, back in 2002, Eugene publicly railed on our society for being sexually saturated. He made a statement, "We're probably the most immoral country, certainly in the Western Hemisphere." He has been removed. Overweight girls reach puberty earlier. But because early puberty alone doesn't necessarily lead to them being overweight in adulthood. Girls who were overweight before their first menstrual period were also 8 times more likely to be overweight women, according to the study.
What are you smiling at?
I'm not. I'm just bringing up a fact. Overweight girls hit puberty first.
So? I didn't have a lot of choices when I was growing up.
I'm reading statistics.
She wasn't morbidly obese. She was just kind of chunky from having a kid.
And missing a tooth.
It wasn't a tooth right up front. It wasn't even a good one.
I understand.
It was off to the side. Wasn't immediately visible when she came up.
Mm-hmm.
Unless she said something. I was 16.
I understand.
I didn't care. But my loins was cooking. I had to do something with it. I didn't care if it was a fat chick or not.
I understand. It's okay. And you look at you now.
I know, but I'm not shaking that one, and I don't know why. Go ahead.
I don't know why that bothers you. More than 600 truckers gathered in their big rigs. This was in Florida yesterday to protest the rising gas. I don't know why they think this is going to work. They're going to block the highways, make everybody mad, make everybody late, just to say, hey, you know what? Gas prices are too high. Trucks included tractor trailers, dump trucks, box trucks. Florida Turnpike Highway at the Miami-Dade County was all stopped up for hours. Basically, they wanted to say to the governor, we need some concessions to make gas prices cheaper for us. The airlines get them. You know, other people get them. We don't get
them. Why don't you just up your cost to transport? Is there a cap on that? Can you not?
What is it?
What is it, Rob?
Sorry, I just got off the phone with Firewater. We're good to go for that little thing you wanted to do with Gavin.
I don't know what you're talking about.
The water hamster.
Okay, so they'll let us put that thing in the pond?
Yeah, they said no problem.
All right, did you call Costume World to get a hamster outfit?
I'm working on that.
All right. Gavin does that, then I'll go.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I wouldn't miss it for the world if he does that. We've all been trying to sleep at one point or another, and a neighbor's car alarm's going off. You thought many times about going out and shooting it. Well, this guy did in California. It was alarm rage. A man annoyed by his noisy car alarm, and his neighbor fired at least 3 bullets into a Toyota Camry that was parked outside his apartment. David Owen has now been arrested and put in jail. Are you breaking?
I'm just waiting for you to hit a good story to end on.
Radio station fined $250,000 for the Smackfest.
No, we already talked about that.
All right. Runaway bride's lawn mowing duty.
For who?
She's just out mowing the county lawn. You know, that runaway bride check.
For how long?
She will have, 120 hours of doing that. She just started this week.
Outstanding.
Okay, Forbes magazine has come up with the folks that made the most money. You won't believe who made the most money last year in Hollywood. You'll never guess.
Yeah, I read this.
Oh, you won't? Okay. Never mind, you'll guess it then. It was Will Ferrell, made $40 million, followed by Johnny Depp at 37. Will Smith made 35. Tom Cruise, 31. Denzel Washington, 30. Adam Sandler, 28. Brad Pitt made $25 million.
I don't understand the Will Ferrell thing.
I don't either. Well, he just made $20 million apparently for some NASCAR movie that's coming out. It's not even out yet.
That don't make any difference. What was that movie he was in? Anchorman.
Yeah.
Only reason I liked that was the other guys that were in it. I couldn't stand him. Yeah. And Christina Applegate. You ever look at her forearms?
No.
They're freaking hairy.
Are they really?
Yeah.
You love that.
Yes. Go on.
Okie dokie. I think you had something else to add. And according to an insider, Paris Hilton now won't even hang out with Tara Reid on The Wild on set. She says she makes her look like a slut. The insider says Tara has been following Paris with a camera trying to get her on, but she will not sign. Have you seen pictures of Tara Reid?
Mm-hmm.
Look at this.
I saw the one where her nipple came out.
No, this is, it's like bad liposuction or something.
Is that a bad print?
No, it's not a bad print. It's all, her stomach's like all bubbly and it looks like it's bad lipo. Why would you go out in public if you've had lipo and it turned out bad?
All this other stuff, is that bruising or is that the print that you got?
No, that's bruising. Bruising and bumps and just, ooh. They even look worse in color. I just printed in black and white.
Did you see these? That is nasty.
Ew.
Yeah. You got something to good end with?
I just have Young Buck and Lloyd Banks are back out of jail and back on the anger management tour. As we heard yesterday, they got arrested on Monday night after their show in the Madison Square Garden. The NYPD pulled them over, pulled a van over. Right at the end of the show, one of the guys said, by the way, F the cops. And the cops decided to pull them over and they found guns in the car, so they spent 2 days in jail. They're back on the anger management tour. I'm J.D. Ryan. There's news and information.
Show.
Looking to get your Irish dig nickel.
Hi, Gail.
Hi, Russ.
Let me ask you something.
What?
This Wellbutrin
uh-huh.
that I'm on. Mm-hmm. Is one of the side effects irritability?
I guess it's a possibility. Seems like all of them make you irritable, though.
Mm. Does that go away, or is it just going to be something I'm stuck with?
Well, I have a feeling that as long as there's people in the world that affect you the way they do,
yes,
you're going to be irritable.
Seems to be worse the last couple of weeks, especially
really?
Today. There's just something about, just I noticed it right in the middle of JD's newscast. I just wanted to reach over and just slap the f*** out of him.
Jesus. I know, I felt that.
Maybe you should double your dosage.
I already did.
Oh, what are you taking, 150?
300.
Well, that's not bad.
Well, it started at 150, and then Venegas bumped it up to 3.
Okay. How long have you been on 3?
About 4 days.
Oh, well, give it a little more time. Anytime you're within a week to 2 weeks of increasing a dosage of it, there's going to be a, you know, and it probably wouldn't take 2 weeks to see what levels off with it, but if you stay irritable, then
I just, the last few days, week, everything is fingers on a chalkboard. I don't care what it is.
Mm. At work, everywhere?
Yes.
Well, I was going to ask.
And especially you
else.
And I haven't figured out why.
What have I done?
I don't know.
Okay.
Hmm. I'm trying to make sure that it's me before I crawl up your ass.
I can tell. I can tell you're very edgy.
It probably has nothing to do with chemistry. It probably has everything to do with
JD.
You.
With what?
What did you say, Gail?
I said it probably has nothing to do with chemistry. It probably has to do with the fact that there's stuff weighing on you, and JD is probably the closest person to you in the whole wide world. So that's who you're going to vent with. What do you think?
I don't know. I'm not taking it out on Amy.
Well, good. Hang in there, JD.
Mm-hmm. Maybe we should hug.
Huh?
We should hug.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, we should. We always
again?
Feel better after a hug. Yeah, we always,
say it again.
We always feel better after a hug.
No, we don't.
Yes, we do.
No.
Yeah,
because right now, if we have a hug,
right
after the hug,
right.
I'm going to slap the f*** out of you.
I wouldn't hug him right now.
It's the best time to hug. The very best time.
Maybe you should shoot something off his head.
Why are you back on the hug crap?
Because it releases the feel-good hormone when people hug.
I think he'd be better off with aerobics and releasing endorphins.
Than a hug?
I've... Dan, hunt down Venegas. Sorry, Gail, I'm going after a second opinion.
Well, I can't say that I blame you.
All right. What do you got?
Well, I've got Toyota of Plano and CompUSA. This Saturday, come to CompUSA. Get 10% off instantly on any HP printer under $1,000. Plus, come and see demos of the world's fastest photo printer from HP. See store for details. CompUSA, we got it. We get it. Carrollton, southbound 35 Simmons. In Carrollton, right around, I think they just cleared it, never mind. Westbound LBJ at Plano Road, there's a wreck. And then on eastbound 635, right around Jupiter Road, they just cleared a stalled car. Northbound Central past 635, the right lane is blocked and traffic's backed up to Meadow Road. Eastbound I-30 before Sylvan, the right lane's blocked. You're back up to Westmoreland and in Allen on northbound Central at Exchange Parkway, the two right lanes blocked. Bethany Road is the backup on that one. It's also brought to you by JCPenney. The JCPenney two-day sale tomorrow and Saturday. Entire stock of Arizona tops or bottoms. Buy one, get one for just $1. It's all inside JCPenney. I'm Gail Lightfoot on the Russ Martin Show.
You know, with a bunch of Spy America Online, go to live1053.com for your free trial. 76 for the low, 97 tomorrow. We have 95 now at live1053.
The George taking my mom out, I don't know if that would bother me. I don't know what it is about sitting here while you're reading the news where I just want to reach over and slap. I'm not sure where this is coming from.
I can feel it. It's been a couple of weeks. You've been very edgy.
Have you noticed a change in him?
In me?
I'm talking to Chloe.
Oh.
Getting an outside of opinion.
Okay.
Because if somebody agrees with me, then I know it's not me and it's not the well Butrin and it's you.
What?
And if it is you,
yeah.
I'm going to slap the
I have to hit you back.
No, it wouldn't be a good idea right now.
Why?
I'm strung out on this. Did you get a hold of Venegas?
No, I'm waiting on Rob for his number.
I know it.
Oh, sorry.
Are you taking the Wellbutrin? What are you taking it for?
I don't know, got on it.
We didn't just start taking it for no reason. Hello? Carlos.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Just finished eating dinner.
At 6 o'clock?
Yeah, I ate early.
Yeah.
What's up?
What are some of the side effects of this Wellbutrin?
Initially, it's going to be a little bit of fatigue.
Yeah.
It's not going to be, well, some people act differently. Some people have had very bad emotional irritability with the medication once they started it.
I got that. I have that really bad right now.
Right now?
Yeah.
Hadn't you been off of it for a couple of days?
The Wellbutrin?
Yeah.
No, just one day.
Just one day?
Mm-hmm. Isn't that what I said?
I'm sorry? You restarted it again today or yesterday?
Today. Because I was off of it yesterday, one day.
Yeah, but you were on 150 milligrams for about a 2-week period without that emotional lability.
Right.
That we call it.
I understand. I was
could
there.
Could be the 300 milligrams that you're on now. Is just a little bit too much for you, so drop down to 150.
All right. And what's going to happen at 150?
Probably the same thing you were when you were taking it for the 2-week period of time. You won't get the labile effect, the emotional, I guess I'm assuming that you're a little short and short-tempered, testy or whatever. It should go back down.
Yes, I said that.
You should not be experiencing that. There was a question of Cymbalta.
Trey said he heard about that someplace.
Yeah, and I was going to call you afterwards.
Yeah, what is that?
Ask you about. That's
right. And you know, if you prescribe it for me, to go ahead and write 4 or 5 prescriptions, because everybody up here is going to want to be on it. JD's on Wellbutrin. He got no clue why.
He knows why. Yeah, it's like a fourth generation of the antidepressant. It's supposed to be, you're taking it in the evening, and it's supposed to be not as labile as the other ones, kind of like the Zoloft.
I don't know what that means.
It doesn't have the roller coaster kind of emotional effects that you would say to right now at Wellbutrin.
Mm.
It doesn't do that. It's been on the market about 6 to 8 months, and a lot of patients are being switched over to it when they pretty much maxed out the other antidepressant effects and they're no longer working, or they haven't reached the potential of what the medication should be doing.
And what's it called again?
Cymbalta.
Do I need that?
I was going to ask off the air to see if, you know, just to discuss it with you.
What do you want to know?
Well, number one, I wanted to know what effect you were getting on the Wellbutrin at the 300 milligrams, and I guess today answered the question. I haven't been listening, so I don't know. Have you been more short than before? I mean, kind of testy, irritable, short-tempered, just an edge, I guess.
Yes.
You have been?
Yes.
There's nothing else that's going on. Everything is exactly the same, except for the increasing of the Wellbutrin.
Right.
There's no.
Why don't you ask me again and see if my answer changes?
Well, I want to be sure that I'm as specific as possible with you.
I'm pissed off, and I can't shake it.
Okay. Then Russ, go back down to the 150.
All right. Well, am I going to get the other benefits if I go back down to 150?
It was those 2 weeks that you were on it. Was were you as testy as you are now on the 150? How did you feel on the 150?
I felt okay, but I didn't get any. There was no. I didn't know why I was taking it.
Okay.
If I'm taking it just to get me irritable, it works.
Well, yeah, obviously, I guess it's worked then, if that were the end result you were looking for, but it's not.
Mm-hmm.
Drop back down to the 150.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And then. We'll see how you're doing. Probably tape you off of it, because if you're not getting the effect that you were initially looking for when we first started this little adventure, then 300, you can't tolerate it because of the emotional lability that you're having. So we may have to take you off of it.
Okay. How long before this irritability goes away?
Well, if you drop down to 150, probably over the next 24 to 48 hours, you should start feeling like you were before.
All right.
Yeah, because you seemed pretty testy yesterday for a short period of time, and I was writing it off that you weren't on the medication. You'd been off it for a day.
Mm-mm. No, you showed up yesterday. I didn't know you were coming.
I was made aware that you kind of knew I was to take the blood. So
the last conversation you and I, the last conversation you and I had was you weren't coming.
Russ, that was last week.
Okay. Have you and I talked since then, where you said you're coming to get blood?
over the weekend, I tried to return your phone calls and left messages. And
so
I,
the answer,
I,
the
I
answer is no.
Yesterday morning, right. Assuming that he had spoken to you because he sees you every day.
No.
Okay. Bad assumption on my end. Fine.
So that had nothing to do with me being irritable.
I just told you when I saw you, kind of, you know, you seemed kind of upset and stuff, and I don't know why, and now I found out that you were off the Wellbutrin release for a day, and so I gave you some other samples to get you back on the medication.
I'd love to stab you. I'm sorry, what?
Nothing.
Stab your doctor. Wellbutrin.
Been this pissed off in a long time.
Nothing's happened.
That's it. There's nothing going on. That's why I know it's this, because everything else is fine.
Yeah.
So this is going to be another drug that we're going to taper off of, and I'll start on a new one?
Let's taper you off of this one, and we can discuss if you want to start another one.
All right.
I mean, it makes no sense getting pissed off at me. I'm trying to help you.
I didn't say I was pissed off at you.
Well, you're acting just like you are.
I'm pissed off at everybody, and I happen to be talking to you right now.
Yeah, well, you know what? I mean, I'm not trying to do anything to help you. Other people are, too, so it makes no sense you getting pissed at me.
I didn't say I was pissed at you.
Well,
I'm pissed in general, and it's because of the crap that you put me on. I'd love to stab you.
I mean, you're pissed at everybody. That's including me.
Yeah, could you stay on the phone till 7?
Yeah, then I get the brunt of everything.
You good.
So if I go back down to 150, should I just stop it? Do I have to taper off on this?
Just taper off of it like you do with the Lexapro. Just taper off of a couple of days and then stop. And
well,
what
would happen if I just stopped cold turkey?
You're probably going to get as irritable as you were yesterday. You're going to be that way until the medication starts tapering off, which is about 24 to 48 hours on its own.
Okay.
I just much rather it be smoother, and that way no one has to put up with this.
Don't try and turn this back on me. You're the one that made me swallow this crap.
Oh, well, you know what? It's not like you went into this blind. We talked about it.
You didn't tell me that irritability was going to be a part of this.
You're choosing not a lot of people that get the irritability part.
Well, I got it.
Yeah, I know. I can tell.
I don't understand you. All right, I'll taper off.
Thank you.
You've been very kind. I appreciate your help.
Yeah, don't say it sarcastic. I'm just trying to help you, man. I mean, geez.
I said thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Quack.
Stop it.
He did this.
Well, you'll be fine. Don't slap me.
Where did you go a couple seconds ago when I was talking to him?
I had to fart, and I didn't want to twist you off with my bubble.
All right. I got no business being on any of this stuff. Because it goes against everything I've been talking about forever. I think any anxiety I've got just comes from doing the show. That's it. You don't take pills to deal with life.
Right. The kind of anxiety that you have, I believe you're right.
And it seemed to gotten worse as the show's gotten more successful. So the two tie in together. Right. You got the cause and effect.
Look what Dave Chappelle did. Same deal. Is the more the pressure was, the more success was, the more he kind of freaked out.
I got nothing to be depressed about. I got no reason to have anxiety. I got no reason to be bitching about anything. But I do. So you take the both. If you want to be successful, you're going to get the anxiety to go along with it.
I think so.
Is that Eddie again? Yes, Eddie.
What up, Slade? Yeah. Slade, man. Look like we know how to get a good show out of you, man. All we have to do is take you off your medicine like they do Mike Tyson right before the show, and you'll spin your ass slap up out the roof of the building.
Is that what they do with him before a fight? They take him off his meds?
Yep, before a fight, they take him off his meds, and he just rips somebody apart. You know you turn into Val, right?
Valerie?
Yeah, you turn into Valerie.
No.
Uh-huh, batting down the hatches. Yeah.
No. And it just dawned on me today, it's got to be the medicine because nothing's going on.
Yeah, nothing's happening in your old...
I haven't talked to Amy the last 4 or 5 nights. She'd come over.
You have not spoken to her?
Well, we talked, but it wasn't the relationship kind of cuddle-up crap
so
that she wants.
So you're staying away from her to avoid problems?
Yeah, because I know if we get together and have that cuddly relationship crap that she wants, there's a chance that we're going to get in a fight because I'm going to snap at her.
Smart that you see that instead of, as opposed to what I normally do is I jump right in the middle of that crap and I end up in a fight.
That's just going to piss me off more. Yeah. So I know if I just kind of back away. It's funny. I was on the couch. I think it was Monday or Sunday night. I think it was Sunday night. Having some watermelon. I was in my zone. I'm watching TV and everything's cool. She looks over at me and she says, "Can I have a bite?" I almost shoved it all in her face.
You need to get off everything.
Just out of absolutely nowhere.
Just a rage?
It's like she screeched, "Can I have a bite?"
That's odd.
And it was really, it took a lot of control not to just take that whole half a watermelon and shove it right in her.
Christ.
Like that scene where What's-His-Face took that grapefruit and shoved Spencer Tracy right in her puss.
Mm-hmm. But she hadn't done anything. She just asked for a bite.
I understand.
I've been there. I mean, I totally understand.
So I'm not really sure why I'm still taking this stuff. And even on 150, what's supposed to be the benefit? I don't feel, nothing's changed. I don't feel any better.
Mm. Just get off it. Got everything.
Alcohol's done me well the whole time.
Get back on it. That seems to be your medicine of choice. What's the difference? It's all going through your liver, and you know how to work that.
I can control the dosages on the alcohol.
You know your zone. You know what it's going to do for you.
Hi, Carla.
Hi.
Yes?
I feel your pain, Russ. I've taken Wellbutrin and I'm taking Cymbalta and have been for like the last 9 months. It's a really great anti-anxiety antidepressant. I was severely full of anxiety and irritable. The Wellbutrin made it worse. But the Cymbalta really levels you out very well. It might work for you.
Does it dope you up?
It has a somewhat sedative feel to it.
Do you know you're doped up?
No, you don't. You just know when you're not. Let's put it that way. You can definitely tell the difference.
Mm-hmm.
But I take a mood stabilizer with mine as well, so I got a little cocktail going.
What are you taking all this stuff for?
For severe anxiety and depression and irritability.
Oh. Is any of this job related, or are you just,
most of it's job related.
What do you do?
I am in customer service.
I'm with you.
I deal with a lot of angry people. So, I take Depakote and Cymbalta, and, what is the other one?
I wonder how the hell they figured that she needed more than one drug
to make a cocktail.
Because some of them counteract with others. And they just work better together. Wellbutrin I took for a long time to help my energy level.
I can't stand you anymore.
It lasted longer than I thought it would.
Now, you're taking Wellbutrin. Why?
Anxiety.
I thought you were on something else.
No.
Are you going to get on the Sambuca stuff with me?
No.
Everybody else seems to lean in that direction. It doesn't matter what I get. I could start taking stuff from menopause and all you guys would be on it.
They'd be on it. No. I'm not. Wellbutrin and then the Benicar. And he wants me to get back on the store.
And you took the Lexapro for a while, didn't you?
Nope, never took Lexapro.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Mm. Or Adderall.
You wanted the Adderall?
Until I found
out. For weight loss.
Until I found out what it seemed to make everybody a little edgy and a little too focused.
It's speed.
Yeah, I didn't need that.
I got a half bottle left.
No, thank you.
Sure?
Positive.
All right. I'll sell it.
It sounds to me, speed will make me edgy, and I don't need that. If I'm taking something to take the edge off,
All right. You want it?
How much?
It's a controlled substance. I could get in a lot of trouble for selling it to you.
It's black market.
Yeah. Make me an offer.
I don't know. What? $50?
I got it. Let me shoot you again with a BB gun.
I've got on really thin shorts today.
Perfect.
Mm-hmm.
This is a controlled substance.
Yeah. You can't get this anyplace else. When Venegas wrote the script for this, he had to make three copies. The state's all over this. You can't get this just anywhere.
In fact, you need to take your pants off for this one.
Yeah.
Dude, I got tidies on.
What?
Tidy whities.
All right. Up to you. Try and get this someplace else. And this is good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
This ain't something that somebody made in their bathroom. This come from the state.
Can we break and I'll think about it?
Sure. Longer you wait, worse it's going to be.
Well, how?
I haven't decided yet. We need to break now?
Yes.
No. All right. We'll do that. But don't want to take any of these? The chick? Yes, Lindsay?
Hi, Russ. I was listening to you bitch about Amy, and, you know, I had the realization, I think I'm perfect for you.
I can't stand your voice.
What? Why can't you stand my voice?
I want to stab you in the vocal cords.
Well, that's because you're pissy, because you're PMSing.
Mm. How old are you?
I'm 27.
Are you cute?
Well, yes. Yeah. I wouldn't be calling if I wasn't.
Yeah, you would.
No, I wouldn't.
Everybody thinks they're cute. Then they get up here,
okay,
and it looks like they just climbed out of the swamp.
Mm-hmm. All right. Have you seen much, like, dog events on TV?
Dog events?
Yes.
No.
Like, the different dog, like, athletic competitions that they have, like the agility or the frisbee or the dock diving?
Okay.
Okay, have you seen the doggies that run down the ramp and they jump off into the water and they measure how far they go?
Sure.
Have you seen that?
No.
Oh, well, okay, I'm just checking. Well, I've been on Letterman doing that, and...
How far were you able to jump?
Well, I didn't jump, the dog...
Very nice.
I took too long to get there.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show. Now, back to the Russ Martin Show.
I want to talk about me, want to talk about I, want to talk about number one on my, what I think, what I like, what I know.
Now's a perfect time to have read me foundation requests.
But occasionally, I want to talk about me.
Is that chick again?
I want to talk about me.
Yes, Lindsay.
Yes, it's that chick again. You didn't let me finish. I didn't even get to tell you what I look like.
All right.
You want to hear?
Well, you were going off on a tangent about dogs jumping in the water. I didn't associate the two.
Okay. Sorry. I digress.
All right.
All right. I'm 27.
Mm-hmm.
Never been married.
All right.
Have no children. Don't want any children.
Mm-hmm.
I have four-legged hairy ones. And those are all the ones that I want. Ever.
Oh,
no, my
God. Hold on. I think Gavin hit the delay, too. Hold on, sweetie. That's the only upside about satellite radio is some of those things you could let scooch by.
No, and you could have.
Yeah. All right, guys. Go ahead.
But, yes, I hate guys that are like, basically, you know, when you're bitching about Amy and how she's always like, let's talk about us, meh, that's why I'm still single.
Mm.
Because that's what the majority of the guys that I've gone out with want, and I'm like, get off of me. You know, I'm like, leave me alone. Can we not just sit here and watch TV? I'm like, what?
I don't get that out of Amy a whole lot of, you know, this typical, what are you thinking about? Where do you see this relationship going?
Mm-hmm.
I don't get a lot of that. But there are times that I just want to be alone, and sometimes she wants to talk.
I know.
And I'm not in the mood.
Yeah, I understand that. Do you tell her? Do you say, I'm not in the mood, and then she gets whiny?
She understands pretty quick and leaves me alone.
Because
she knows the penalty of noodling me.
Yes, I understand. Oh, I didn't finish telling you what I look like, did I?
Oh, yeah. I have no idea so far.
I go off on tangents. Mm-hmm. Sorry. ADD.
Okay. All right.
But anyway... I'm about 5 3'4", like right in between. Mm-hmm. I weigh about 110 pounds.
Okay.
And about 80% of that is in the upper area. And I have red hair and blue eyes.
So what are your measurements? Because they sound like they're going to be hideous.
What do you mean?
What are your measurements?
I'm a 32 double D, and I have about a 23-inch waist.
And
a little butt, probably. I don't know exactly what my butt measurements are, but I'd say they're probably about 31, 32.
Are your boobs real?
Yes. Mm-hmm. I got them from my grandma.
Can't wait to see those. What part of town are you in?
I live in east-ish Texas, like outside of Mesquite.
Oh.
But
where are you right now?
Right now, I'm in Plano on my way to a dog training appointment. I'm a dog trainer.
Oh.
So.
Well, just email me a picture later.
Email you a picture. All right, I'll have to find a picture.
Okay.
Most of my pictures that I have are all from, like, dog events when I'm, you know, like, been out in the sun all day.
That's fine. Just tell me which one's you.
Ha, ha, ha. I don't think I'll have to do that.
Okay.
I'm the one with the red hair. The dogs have black hair.
I got it.
You'll know the difference.
Just send me a couple of pictures. I'll assume the one with the biggest is you.
That would be a very good assumption, considering both my dogs are male.
Okay.
All right. I'll do that when I get back, whenever I get back home.
All right.
All right. Thank you for letting me finish now.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Must be catching whatever you have, because I want to stab that bitch.
Yeah. I could, as she's talking, I could see the handle of the knife just hanging out of her neck.
Yeah. I'm going to...
Just right smack dab in the windpipe.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I could visualize the whole time she was talking.
Just dangling.
Mm-hmm. All right, who wants what?
Okay, this guy's 18 years old, emailing because he needs help. Now, you probably get a lot of these kind of emails. Hope you'll take time to read mine. Born with spina bifida. Had about 30 operations to try to correct it to no avail. Finally, April 5th of this year, had a leg amputated to try to get rid of the problem, or I thought so, since the operation.
Why are we cutting his leg off, cure his spina bifida?
I don't know.
I thought your spine was in the other half.
I believe it is. I don't know.
I don't think I'd go back to that doctor.
Since the operation, I've had an infection in the bone. The doctor finally thought they'd got rid of it, but that wasn't the case. While I was at home, I was working, I got a new car. I was hospitalized on Thursday, doesn't say which Thursday, and have had two operations since then.
Do I need to sit down?
Yeah, probably.
All right. Go ahead.
On Thursday. Two operations since then, and fixing to have another one tomorrow. We just got this, so it's been tomorrow. With all this going on, I'm unable to make my car insurance and car payment for the next month of September. You feel better?
That's a nice release.
Okay, good. My parents have made my car payment for this month, but they're strapped for cash as it is. So I was wondering if you could help me and my family out. Altogether, the bill is $557 for September.
Okay.
I listen to your show, and I know you hate these kind of emails.
All right.
But you're my last resort, or I lose my car, as well as my transportation to work after I get out of this place. So please consider helping me out this time. One thing I hate doing is asking people for help anytime. I was raised to work for what I have, but this leg is holding me back. Please, Mr. Martin, help me. If you need more information, here's some phone numbers.
Uh-huh. No. Okay. I'm not making car payments.
But
you need to find a doctor that understands what spina bifida is and stop cutting your legs off.
You got an infection, apparently.
No. Is that the only foundation request?
That's the only one so far.
What else are you holding?
This is from Men's Health Magazine. It's found if you're good or bad in bed.
We already know the answer to that.
Well, but this will...
You know the answer to that.
I certainly do. Yeah.
How many questions?
Eight.
All right.
It's pretty easy.
Okay.
Number one, when does foreplay start for you? A, when our lips first...
Are these going to be cute questions?
Some of them are. They try to be cute. You know, men's health. They try to be cutesy.
All right.
A, when our lips first touch. B, when I first buy her a beer. Or C, when her shirt comes off. When does foreplay start?
That doesn't make any sense.
It's just women like foreplay to stretch out as far back as the first encounter of the night.
All right, so I guess the answer is going to be A.
Should be B, when I borrow the first pint of beer.
So B's the answer to this?
B's the best of the three answers, yeah. So.
All right, go ahead.
All right. So I guess we're not going to keep score. I'll just tell you as we go along. Which animal is she most like during sex? A, a monkey. Inquisitive and playful.
Love monkeys.
B, a tigress on the hunt and aggressive.
I'd rather screw a monkey.
or C, a trapped rabbit.
In bed?
Mm-hmm.
Going with the monkey.
All right. The sizzle fades when men always take the lead. To break out of the rut, spend the evening flirting with her instead of making the first move. So draw her into your dance. Actually, you want her to be a tigress.
I want her to be a monkey.
Well, all right. In this case, the answer would have been tigress.
I'm going to disagree with that one.
All right.
She's a monkey.
What do you touch? What do you touch to drive her wild? A, yourself. B, her clitoris. Or C, the skin between her fingers.
The webbing between her fingers?
Yeah, that's what it says. What do you touch to drive her wild?
I'm going to go with the...
Actually, women are loaded with pleasure points all over their body. Use the unexpected ones to turn her on the most, the skin between her fingers.
Good. That stinks the less. Please.
All right. She digs what you're doing, so you stay the course. A, do it faster and harder. B, C, find something else she likes. She digs what you're doing. So do you stay the course, do it faster, or find something else?
I'm going to guess that they want you to say C.
Actually, you're correct on this one.
All right.
Too often, men take a positive reaction and increase the speed and just make it harder and harder and harder. They said, once she finds something, just stay there for a little bit and move on.
All right.
How thick is your position playbook? A, I've worn out my copy of the playbook. B, I'm a missionary man. C, I like the classics with some experimentation. I know you've got one position.
Read it again.
How thick is your position playbook? You know, have a lot of positions, you do.
I can't focus right now on Channel 11. They're showing that monkey that smokes cigarettes.
It really is a riot to watch Charlie taking a puff and then blowing smoke. And while it looks funny, zookeepers are now worried about Charlie's health. And they're trying to figure out how to help this ape go cold turkey.
Have you guys not seen that?
I've seen that.
Have you seen it close?
He's got an attitude on top of everything else.
Yeah, the way he yells a cigarette.
Right. Like what? Are you looking at me?
Now, how does he get those?
Throw them in there.
Oh, okay.
Same thing at the Dallas Zoo.
I mean the Fort Worth Zoo.
The monkeys out there smoke?
They don't smoke, but what it is, if you throw something at them, they'll throw it right back at you. I swear to God.
What do you normally chunk?
Last time, I would think I was chunking like popcorn, and he would pick up a rock and throw it back. I am not kidding in the least bit. Told my roommate, he went the next day, he goes, I'll be damned, the monkey throwing stuff back at me too.
It's because they're sexed up.
Yeah, they are. So your position, how many positions do you do?
I don't even know the question.
How many positions do you do?
Normally it's one, maybe two if okay. I'm horny.
All right, well then, okay, I'll mark you down as B, that's the lowest score.
All right, what is the lowest score?
That is one point.
All right.
She's happiest A, in the morning, she glows, B, in the early evening before sex, or C, right after sex. She's happiest.
What was the right answer?
To this one, there's no right answer. You're just going to get the score on how good you are. In bed.
Ask me the last one again.
She's happiest in the morning, she glows, B, in the early evening, right before sex, or right after sex.
I don't like sex at night.
You don't?
I like it in the morning.
I do too, actually. Yeah. Unless it's going to be really drawn out and do the bath thing and the candles and the whole, make an evening.
Do you do that every time you guys have sex?
No.
You always got the bath and the candles and the other stuff?
That's a special evening.
How often does the sex swing come out?
Every other week. Sometimes every 3 weeks.
Do you ever set in it and she gets you?
Like, gets me how?
I don't know how these things work.
No. Well, yeah, I mean, I sit in it sometimes. And
what?
She'll straddle.
So you guys sit in that?
Together, yeah.
Is that what it's for?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Why can't you just do that sitting in the sofa?
Because you have freedom to move your legs on either side, but you don't have it in the sofa. You have free air around you.
How much weight will that sex swing hold?
350 pounds. actually, I'm sorry, this one holds 400.
Okay.
All right. To impress a woman in bed, you take off her bra with one hand. I know that's your answer. Compliment every butt, her every body part, or show her why you're called the mouth.
I like to lick on stuff.
Do you?
Oh, yeah.
You get 2 points for that instead of one. All right. And finally, sex sounds like A, sports center, B, heavy breathing, or C, she speaks in tongues.
She grunts a lot. What would that be?
That would be
sports center.
That would probably be heavy breathing.
All right.
You get 2 points for that.
Okay.
Let me add up here real quick. And you get a total of...
Where are you going?
Shoot. You want to go fart?
Is that really where you're going?
Yeah.
All right, we'll go fart.
No!
Ow! God! Yeah, you get... Yeah, you're bad in bed. So you're the guy who's giving us all a bad name.
I'm what?
You're the guy who's giving us all a bad name.
Yeah. I've already said I'm bad in bed. I don't like foreplay. I don't like banging around for a while. I like to do the stuff, and if you get an orgasm, great, but I'm not banging all night. And if you got one, don't sit on it.
What does that mean?
I don't wait around. Don't hold it back so you can enjoy the moment. Have it. Jesus. And after you have it, tell a brother.
Does Amy tell you?
No. She just grunts a lot and grabs the sheets, and after a while I'm going, did you?
Are we finished here?
Yeah.
Can I?
She says, yeah, okay. Well, at what point were you going to give me the heads up so I could stop banging your ass?
Sounds so romantic when you put it that way.
Well, then tell me.
I know. Give me a little sign.
I thought you could tell. I don't know with you. You're always screaming.
Well, really loud.
No, it's not loud.
Just moaning.
Yes.
Cool.
We need a break.
Please.
You all right?
Be all right.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show. The Russ Martin Show.
All aboard!
Dan. The kid going to Lancaster that did the 6 robberies, is he quarterback?
I believe so, yeah.
Mm-hmm. We were talking about that during the break. It's just fascinating that the school district side, we don't care if we've got an admitted soon-to-be felon. As long as he throw the ball, gives a rat's ass.
Apparently.
And he can run.
Yeah.
So we can hit you from both angles.
Rob, that was the guy from No Morning News.
Oh, have that over here.
Raglan?
Yeah. Raglan. Did that Raglan guy call you back? I still don't get how he justifies, well, this. Who benefits if we take this kid off the field? I don't give a rat's ass who benefits. He's not supposed to be there.
Shouldn't even be in school, in a normal school. Should be, as Mondo called earlier, said alternative school. If you break any rule, you go to alternative school. And they don't have football programs. But because this kid's a star and people are looking at him, apparently the rules don't apply.
They change a little bit if you can throw a ball.
Isn't that weird? And the district will get no pressure. The parents aren't going to complain. Teachers aren't going to complain. The district unto itself, they've already made the decision that he's okay. Where would pressure come from? UIL, I guess they can decide one way or the other.
Hold on. What is it, Jim?
Hey, Dan don't know what the hell he's talking about, man. He's a wide receiver. He's not a quarterback.
That doesn't change the story, though.
Oh, I agree with you. If I was still in high school, I would say let him play because I would be looking for him. I would be hurting him on the field every chance I got.
And that's what Dan was talking about. All the other schools are going to play against them. They're probably going to go after this kid just as you know, some type of punishment for the 6 aggravated robberies.
definitely. We had a guy that we played whenever I was in high school. It was the only black guy that played on a team that we played against. He was the only one in our district. And this guy got shut down when we played him. I mean, he had like negative yardage for the whole game.
Why
this guy was like running up yards.
Why were you guys jumping on him?
What do you think?
Did you say because he was black?
That's it. I'm kind of like, you know, I'm kind of like...
I know what you're kind of like.
JD over there.
You're what?
I said, I'm kind of like JD over there. I got to get in his...
Oh, JD telephone.
No.
No, this
you're not in my corner at all.
Yeah, he is.
No, he's not.
Yeah.
Not at all.
The grand draft.
Shut up.
Unbelievable that people in Stan Age even still think that way.
I thought he meant the black guy had done something.
Yeah, no, yeah, was well, accused of something.
Why do you think? We had the best reason on the planet for jumping him. He's a... What, you freaking redneck?
Unbelievable. I'm proud of it. This guy's proud of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, we shut him down. Negative yardage.
I was waiting for him to finish the story. Well, this guy had gone out and stole a car or robbed somebody. Nah, we got him because he's black.
Yeah, wait a minute. So he's acquitting a guy who's done six felonies to a black fella.
Yeah.
He's guilty.
Well, you know, if he's black, he's bound to do something sooner or later. We might as well get him before it actually happens.
Preemptive.
What's wrong with you?
Oh, God. Unbelievable.
And Ragland thinks it's best to keep this guy, this columnist with the news, keep this guy playing. Because you know what? This could be his only, this could bring him out of this slump that he's having where it was a bad decision. It was, you know, everybody makes a bad decision. He made six in one night.
With a gun.
Pistol whipped somebody, as far as, if I understand the story.
The story
right.
is correct.
And then shot at somebody when they were running
as
off.
As they were fleeing, shot at them. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right. That's not a momentary lapse in reason. That's insanity.
Let me see the Ragland thing again. Plenty of time to punish Brandon Jackson if he, as police charge, was involved in robbing six people at gunpoint. Regardless of the outcome, the kid is already in a lot of legal trouble, and he will be forever stigmatized as a kid who robbed those people, especially if he's able to rise above this and reach any level of success in our society. Before we rush to conclude that he should not be allowed to play his final year at high school football in Lancaster High, we must ask ourselves these two questions. How will it benefit Brandon or society if he never steps on the field again?
Well, it benefits society because you make a point that if you act this way, you don't get to play football or anything else. You don't get to play in the sandbox.
Why is that even a question? Well, why does that need an answer?
He's trying to, obviously there's probably somebody somewhere that's made the other side of this argument. And obviously, everybody has. Nobody can really come up and say, yeah, this makes sense.
How will it hurt him or society if he hangs up his cleats? I know a lot of people will argue that allowing him to play will send the wrong message. That's not an argument. That's a fact.
It does.
He's out running around. He's already admitted he did it. He's got that ankle bracelet on.
During practice.
I don't agree with that assertion. Brandon hasn't gotten away with anything, and he won't. Right now, he is.
As of now. And he'll play this whole season, because even if he's convicted in October when he goes to trial, there'll be appeals. He'll go all the way through Christmas.
And you know what? Maybe that's what Lancaster is hoping for.
Oh, sure.
Initially, I thought, well, we'll just get him, and if we get two or three games out of him before they lock him up, dandy. But you're right. I forgot about the appeals process. He can milk this for another few months, get all the way through the school year, graduate.
Mm-hmm.
Have his high school record behind him and maybe be approached by colleges if they don't lock his ass up.
Get a couple of years. Yeah, get a couple of years and then come out and start his career.
That's the reason you don't let him play.
I agree.
You don't benefit over something like this. And I'm telling you, if he went and held up Ragland sitting in his own house.
Yeah, or his kids.
Yeah. Shoved the gun and pistol whipped one of them, this would have never hit the morning news.
No. You get a point.
And if I didn't already get this paper for free, I'd cancel my subscription.
I had to pay for it.
Why?
Because they weren't throwing it for free.
No, I get this in the Star Telegram. The young man has no prior arrests. This is Ragland.
Mm-hmm.
A 3.53 GPA. Why is that important to me?
It's, well, what it shows
when
is...
when somebody's holding me up or pistol whipping me, I don't care how well they did in school. I just want them to stop.
How'd you do in English? Pretty fine.
Young man has no progress, 3.53 GPA, and a chance at leveraging his athletic skills into a college education. He's also apologized to the victims.
Well, you have to.
I know it might be hard for them to forgive me, but the best thing I can do is pray for them. I feel bad for the family I hurt by doing this.
As you said earlier, did you feel bad after the first one?
Yes.
Second, was it the fifth?
When did the remorse kick in? Is it after fourth or fifth, or finally after sixth? You're going, I got to knock this off.
Yeah.
I'm addicted.
Now the room, that's really kicking in.
Yeah.
Hold on, let me pop this cap off, then I feel really bad.
Yeah. I want to get the entire magic of the holdup.
Yeah.
I don't understand. They're going back and telling me about the kid's past.
Well,
I don't care.
They're going to do that in court. They're going to say, hey, look, this kid's never been in trouble before. It was a bad decision. He's a wacky teenager.
You know what kids do when they're going through puberty.
Crazy. It's hormones.
It's like Dan said earlier. You know what? Obviously, he's a smart kid. He's a self-starter. His first night out robbing people, did it six times and popped a cap at somebody's ass.
What did they say they can get?
Six counts of aggravated robbery, each a first-degree felony, punishable by a prison term of 5 to 99. Does that mean each count he could get 5 to 99?
I believe that's correct.
Jackson admitted taking part in the robbery, six people at gunpoint. Two incidents in January, Garland and Mesquite. I want to take that.
Does it mean he has to get a minimum of five? Or can they plead that out to probation, probably?
I don't know.
I don't either.
Says punishable by a prison term of 5 to 99. For some reason, they say that, then they end up with like 3 years. Well, what happened to the five? Well, you don't understand the legal system.
That's it.
Very complicated. We don't even understand it. Shut up. Hi, Mark.
Hey, what's going on?
Yeah.
I was going to say, you know, in the article he says he doesn't have any prior arrests. Well, it's like, no kidding, neither do I. It's not like it should be a big deal that he doesn't.
Right.
That's the way it's supposed to be, you know?
Yeah, you don't get credit for having a clean record.
Exactly. Exactly. That should be the par.
And this wasn't even an accident where he happened to be in the car with somebody and they went and did something. Then he didn't know how to get out of it later. Six times this all happened on January 18th.
Oh, yeah. It's not like, I was with some buddies and one of them did this just on a whim. It was,
right.
He was probably the ringleader of the deal.
Well, he admitted to being the gunman.
Yeah.
Exactly. I mean, that's not an accident. That's not a thrill. Especially not shooting off at somebody.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, sir.
No problem.
Well, we'll see if his name...
James
Ragland with the morning news calls tomorrow. Possibly I'm being too harsh. I don't understand his position.
It could be.
I don't see anything else in here. One of the mitigating circumstances for me not wanting to kick Brandon to the curb is a level of contribution he has already shown. I just say at the time of the crimes, I was real lost. This is Brandon talking.
Okay.
I couldn't really tell you what I was thinking. I can't tell you if I was thinking. Okay? Remorse is okay, and apologizing is fine, but that don't get you off of this. And it shouldn't get you on the football field.
I have to totally agree with you. You would think at some point somebody above the school district would step in and go, hey, no, knock this off.
Yeah. I'm amazed he even put that in here. One of the mitigating circumstances.
Did he say I'm sorry?
Yeah.
After being caught.
Not wanting to kick Brandon to the curb is his level of contribution. I don't care. I don't care if he was working with charity organizations for the past 15 years. He pistol whipped somebody and shot at him. That erases all the good you've done.
Yeah.
All right, there.
Thank you.
Ready to go, Dan?
All set.
Ready?
Yes. All right. For more information about the Russ Martin Show, pictures, links, video, and webcams, just go to RussMartin.com. If you have questions, about the show, find all the answers at russmartin.info. To instant email the show, and only during the show, just send that to studio@russmartin.com and the other show websites, johndavidryan.com, thegranddragon.com, danantassos.com, gaillightfoot.com, djclo.com, and robriddlemoser.com. For more information about Spittleville, go to spittleville.com. For Black Eddie's weather information website, go to weatherNIG.com. And the official site for KLLI is live1053.com.
All right, what is today, Thursday? Mm-hmm. All right, so it's Likas 101. Tom Likas is next. We'll see you guys tomorrow.
See ya.
You can now listen to The Russ Martin Show anytime you want on the web at russmartin.info. On the Alternative Talk Station.
Live. 105.3.